China gets called out by the Group of Seven over its militarization and intimidation tactics in the South China Sea. In a communique released by foreign ministers of the G7, they oppose China's dangerous use of its Coast Guard and maritime militia to change the status quo by force or coercion. The G7 cited China's use of dangerous maneuvers and water cannons against Philippine vessels. It adds there is no legal basis for China's expansive maritime claims in the South China Sea. The G7 represents the world's leading industrialized democracies, consisting of Canada, France, the United States, Germany, Italy, Japan, and the United Kingdom. China firing back at the United States following Washington's arms control accusations. The U.S. Department of State earlier accused Beijing of failing to adhere to its nuclear testing moratoria, as well as conducting sensitive biological activities for military purposes. Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Lin Jian called the accusations baseless, adding the U.S. should take a look at its own arms control record. He also asserts China is committed to upholding the international law, unlike the U.S., which he accused of stoking major country confrontations.
The report ignores facts and is full of preconceptions. The report smears other countries with baseless accusations on their compliance. China firmly opposes it. We urge the U.S. to stop pointing fingers at other countries, take a hard look at its track record in arms control, disarmament, and non-proliferation, and earnestly respond to the legitimate concerns of the international community on the U.S. compliance.
The Philippine government belies China's claims there exists an internal understanding with Manila on how to handle tensions in the West Philippine Sea. The National Security Council dismisses Beijing's allegations as nothing more than an invention. This statement comes after the Chinese embassy in Manila accused the Marcos administration of abandoning its alleged arrangement with Beijing over the Ayungin Shoal. China's repeatedly made this claim without offering any proof.
This new model is nothing more than a new invention. The propaganda masters at the Chinese embassy are clearly working overtime to sow discord and division in our country for one purpose alone: to push their claim that the Philippines is the one causing tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
The mayor of Tuguegarao City in Cagayan Province hits back at critics over the surge of Chinese students in the province. Mayor Myla Rosario Tingke rejects allegations they are a threat to national security. The mayor says Chinese students have been in the city even before the province agreed to host a military facility under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement. Tingke also denies allegations Chinese students are buying off college diplomas. She calls the accusations racist and discriminatory. The Philippines and Japan expected to sign a reciprocal access agreement before the year ends. This was announced by the National Security Council. The Defense Pact, which is similar to Manila's Visiting Forces Agreement with the U.S., allows both nations to deploy troops to each other's countries and hold joint maritime drills. Tokyo and Manila started negotiations for the agreement in November 2023. The NSC adds several other countries are also expressing interest in having a similar agreement with the Philippines, but they weren't named.
It's moving at a quick pace. No, it's moving at a quick pace. There has been several visits by Japan negotiators to the Philippines. Philippine negotiators have been in Japan as well. In Washington, during the trilateral summit, this was also discussed between the Philippines and Japan. During exchanges between the Philippines and Japan, after the trilateral meeting, this was also discussed, and the Prime Minister of Japan and the President of the Philippines has given the instructions to our negotiators to proceed immediately.
President Marcos earlier said that the defense pact will improve Manila's defense capabilities and clarify that the deal is not meant to antagonize any country. A significant game changer, that's how Philippine security officials are describing the delivery to Manila of the BrahMos missile system, considered to be the fastest cruise missiles in the world. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says it will buttress the country's coastal defense and improve maritime domain awareness. The missile system is part of the $375 million deal signed by the Philippines and India in 2022.
Complementing this maritime, increased maritime domain awareness is the capacity to deter and defend. And one of these deterrence capacities, in addition to our FA-50 fighter jets and our offshore patrol vessels, is the BrahMos missile. So this is more of a deterrence. Na parang kung sakasakali, di ba, mag-iisip-isip yung ibang mga bansa na pasukin yung ating waters, because we now have several batteries of this BrahMos cruise missile, which is going to be deployed to the Philippine Marines.
Filipinos in flood-hit United Arab Emirates appealing for help from the Philippine government. Three OFWs were killed while two others were injured following one of the heaviest rainfall in the Gulf region's history. The Philippine Consulate General in Dubai says some areas are still flooded, hampering their efforts to provide aid and food supply to Filipinos.
Ang mga naapektuhan po nating mga kababayan, minsan sila po ay tumatawag sa amin, hindi sila maabot ng tulong sapagkat meron rin pong dahilan rin po sa tubig. Talaga pong na-overwhelm ang UAE ng sa lakas at volume ng tubig na bumagsak. Pero we are in touch with them. Yung iba po nagsasabi, we have 3 days supply na lang ng pagkain, 2 days supply. Pero nagko-coordinate po kami sa kanila and we're hoping na habang bumababa yung level ng tubig, kami ay makakarating po sa kanila. Ang maganda po naman dito ay, as I said, we are in constant communication with them at sila po ay ating na bibigyan naman ng necessaryng ayuda.
The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration also assures the families of the victims the Philippine government is doing its best to repatriate the remains of the three Filipinos killed in the floods.